At 3R, we want to provide equal opportunities to the people of Africa. And we think that with providing good, fast, stable internet service, with this we enable them to participate in a global economy, to have a better education, and have access to better information faster. I think that that's empowering people and bringing them really, you know, equal opportunities as also the developed countries in the world have.
I think the internet is important to all businesses, and it's been proven. I mean, internet really does help economic development, you know, as well as other developments. I mean, it's very important to have connectivity for the rural areas, but it's also more important for connectivity for businesses.
Even a 1% internet penetration will increase a 1% GDP growth in many different countries. So the growth of internet accessibility and reliability is like directly interlinked with the economy.
Education is the only way out of poverty. You know, most countries in Africa are economically struggling to catch up with the rest of the world. If most of the population of Africa get educated, it would be very easy for those countries to escape from poverty, because an educated mind can deliver better service, better education, better health, better agricultural service, better trade, industry, investment, everything. I believe that education changes everything. So if internet is going to be a good cause for facilitating better teaching, better learning, and education goes on very well, nothing goes wrong.
Everything we do is like online, right? It's not just only us, like, because we're as an incubator and a co-creation space, we also have like startups who are 100% relying also with the internet.
We at Udasi use internet for our daily tasks. Our service, starting from the user interface at our reception desk up to the result delivery, it requires internet connection.
Not just alone is like access, but even like poor quality of internet affects our business.
It was unplanned when COVID broke out. We had a very good online teaching system. By that time, we were like trying our best to deliver both online and home tech kinds of things, not necessarily online, which 100% depends on internet. Because in this case, where you send the students home and try to teach them from here, the availability of internet at the school site only is not enough. You need to also have a better internet access at home with the students. So since it was a challenge, we had a very hard time teaching the students as we wish.
I think in Ethiopia at least, one of the things like we're missing, having 110 million people, is like the lack of proper connectivity. In this case, you know, like we kind of like miss the revolution in Web 2.0, and also like, you know, the upcoming like technology in the last years because of lack of connectivity, and that affects everything, right? That affects agriculture, that affects the quality of education, that affects commerce, any other part of the economy will be affected by the lack of reliable internet.
Of course, having more access make us provide better services to all stakeholders. That means actually we need to communicate with our stakeholders in the UK and the other parts of the world, as we are delivering British international curriculum and having much communication with people from abroad.
Having internet again as a vehicle for to support the Ethiopian economy is not anymore a luxury, or is not anymore is like an option, but a mandatory. So citizens need to be connected through reliable internet so that they can actually perform day-to-day activities. Farmers need to be connected to the internet so that actually they can control their yield, they can monitor their agriculture output, but also looking at the prices so they can negotiate better with buyers. Students need to get quality of education through their mobile phone, through internet. You know, the trade and commerce and formal businesses all needs reliable internet to do that.
Whether we're transforming the economy, helping governments move from a cash-based economy to a more digital economy, leveraging things like CDBCs and so on, whether we're moving from paper-based ID systems to digital ID systems, the common denominator is having connectivity. So we can't really deliver this vision that we have for Cardano without connectivity.
Having more reliable, more faster internet penetration definitely improves our service. And actually, what we have now is truly better than what we had before, but still having better service is really what we wish to have.
We will always choose the best company who will give a best connection.
We have partnered together with K3 Telecom. It's a Swiss-based telecom that's using novel technology, and they already set it up in Sierra Leone in Freetown.
This is the new trend of investments going all across the world, not only in Africa. K3 Telecom, it's a Swiss-based company. What we use is a specific technology patent for K3 Telecom, and it is based on a technology that you cannot find anywhere except with us at the moment. And with 3R and the blockchain, we are hoping that we will achieve a certain target that will enable us not to open one or two operations simultaneously, but to hit, like, our target is to cover as much as possible out of the continent of Africa.
The crucial part is that we need connectivity to deliver really this vision that we have for financial inclusion. So without that, we're not going to achieve that. And really across the continent, we do have many telcos, most of them are based either in the city, but not really covering the more rural areas or the upcoming areas. And also the data costs are really, really high. So like comparing, you know, the cost of data where I live in Germany versus, you know, many places in Africa, it's three times more, yet people don't have those resources. So it's really about, you know, providing affordable connectivity to users, and also providing a robust backbone upon which we can build these technologies. You know, blockchain requires you to be constantly online and have reliable infrastructure, and I think that's what impresses me with 3R, you know, and what you guys have done in Sierra Leone, and how robust the technology is. So it's you know, something that businesses can rely on, something that individual citizens as well can rely on. So, you know, we're very excited, and it fits together with, you know, a whole portfolio of solutions that we're looking at. And it's how do we bring together all these partners to really build an alternative solution to what's out there in the market.
We know there's only one internet provider here in Ethiopia, so because of that, I think that since there's no other competition, you know, they have not really pushed themselves to, you know, make the service better. And it's really a struggle every day in our business.
So what 3R actually building is a platform that's suited for telecoms. We actually want to become the first decentralized blockchain-based telecom platform. And on this platform, we are firstly providing each customer with a digital identity that can be used within our system, but also with time, it should expand also outside of our system. Then we are offering easy access to the services that the ISPs are providing, and we are offering bankless payments. That's really important right now here because people still use a lot of cash because they don't have other means. So they don't have credit cards. Not all of them have bank accounts so that they could pay remotely. And that's really an important thing. And then we are also expanding into providing microloans to our customers. We are expanding into providing telecoms with good solutions that are tackling the usual problems that exist in the telecom. So we are speaking about fraud prevention that can be easily done on the blockchain. We're speaking about privacy-enabled data sharing. The telecoms are always at least partly regulated by the authorities, so they need to provide some information if the authorities ask them to. That's always a bit of a pain point. If it's on the blockchain, if it's privacy enabled, it's far easier. It's also easier to share the data with some third-party service providers on the blockchain. And there are also some experimental features that we want to implement and work on, like tokenizing bandwidth, and with this enabling secondary markets for it. And this could potentially bring like fair pricing for everybody involved.